Good evening. My name is Adam, and I'm a designer for Lego. I'm a fan of this whole Monster stuff, and it's like everything. I love the movies, I love the music, and I was thinking that what we're really lacking is the haunted house, because that's for me personally like something so essential to the whole Monster stuff, like, you know, house with ghosts and broken down, and I basically made a sketch for as an alternative for the Dracula's castle, just without telling anybody. And then my boss came and he was like, oh, that's cool. We could not have it in the original line, but we could make a direct set out of it if you wish. And I was like, obviously, I wish. So that's how it came about. The Lego Haunted House, first ever. I usually build cars and stuff like that. And so I had to face a whole different challenge building from bottom to the top. Haunted houses in movies are always dusty and broken and whatsoever, and to give that away with bricks that are basically new wasn't easy. For example, I tried to mix in some odd pieces and some different profile bricks to give you the illusion of broken stones or whatever, and I tried to make something with the window shutters to give it a wacky feel. I spent many days on just trying to get the feel of the structure and where to put like broken down stuff to not make it too messy, and at the same time like I had it in my mind. There is not many functions in this one. It lives from its detail, actually. So we begin with the chimney that where we use the new profile elements from City to get the broken down appearance of it, and then we use the shutters that are just on one that are connected just on one side to give it the wackiness, and then we use the City brick for the different boards. We also use the new element from Lord of the Rings to make the boarded down windows, and all of it is like connected to one stud, so just to get it crooked and broken. And then there's the inside of the house. The first thing we have is the swinging out fireplace with a bottle ship on it, and we have the first floor with the broken wooden floors and the staircase to the upper floor, and then we have our kitchen with zombie cook, and in the kitchen we have a little old style stove, and we have a table with some jars and some cooking utensils. And moving upstairs, there's this tiny room where Dracula can write letters or whatsoever, and then we have the bedroom with a broken bed, and we have the new character, the Lurch, and then we have the new stickers for some pictures on the walls, and then we have the deer horns above the bed, and we have then we have the stairs to the attic, which worked like this. There is a small lever on the outside, hidden in the chimney, and then you just open the ladder, and you can climb upstairs. And on the attic, there's all kinds of stuff that was left there a long time ago. We have like newspaper tags and some boxes and some crates. And then we have my favorite detail of the whole house, which is the gramophone or the music box that actually uses a hat for the speaker. And then we have also two different records and all kinds of other stuff that might have been there or might be spooky or exciting to explore. So moving back to the outside, I know most of you don't like stickers, but stickers in this set opened us some possibilities that we never had before, and we decided that we can print curtains, which you can see like right there. There's different stickers for different curtains and for some spider webs in the windows that can be placed in different positions, which makes this thing come alive. So the last thing I would like to show you is the whole essence of the house, which is the new ghost. It was made by Gitte, and it is based on the old one that we all know and love, but it's a bit more serious and a bit more detailed than the old one. And with the haunted house, you get two of those. And all the other things that are in the house and all the other details that you'll have to explore by yourself. And I hope you'll have as much fun building it as I had designing it. And thank you for watching.